The best part about math is the crazy amount of things that it actually applies to. Today, we're going to use math to find out how long does it take you to complete a video game? How much food can you eat if you sit at a buffet forever? All that and infinitely more. Let's have a look. What are geometric series? Geometric series are created by adding up the terms of a geometric sequence. The notation we're going to use is Sn, the sum of the first n terms. And that's going to be equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 all the way up until Tn. Is there a formula for it? Well, if Tn is equal to Ar to the n minus 1, is the function that you use in order to generate or calculate each term of the sequence. Then, for the series, Sn is equal to Ar to the n minus 1 divided by r minus 1. Now, what's important here is that the A, the first term of the sequence, is exactly the same A. It's the same number that you are going to use in the series. And that R, the common ratio, is exactly the same R that you use in the formula for the series. So, then we also see that r cannot be equal to 1, and that's because we're dividing by r minus 1. And if anybody clever has ever told you anything, it's that you cannot divide by 0. So let's see how it works. Mbongi is playing a video game with 15 different levels. Each level is harder than the next, as it should be, so it takes him twice as long to complete each new level. The first level takes him 3 minutes to complete. How long does it take Mbongi to finish the entire game? Right? So to finish the entire game, he has to complete each of the levels. So how long it takes him to finish the entire game is going to be the sum of all the time he took to complete each level. So let's see. We're told that it takes him 3 minutes to complete the first level. So that is term 1. That's our A value is 3. And each new level takes twice as long to complete. So our common ratio is 2. We're always multiplying by 2 to get to the next term. So term 2 is going to be 6 and term 3 is going to be 12. Now we want to know how long does it take him to finish the game, so we've got to find Sn. But there are 15 levels, so there are 15 terms that we're adding up, so we're finding S15. So to find S15, we've got to get our formula, and we know in the formula A is the first term, that's 3. Then we also see that R is the common ratio, and that is 2, and then that n there is 15. So we've got all the things that go into our formula, we compute it, and we get 98,301 minutes. So this game is going to take him 68.26 days of continuously playing to complete. So I have a good feeling, or a hope at least, that he's not going to complete the game. Is this any different from arithmetic series? The sum to infinity of a geometric series behaves differently to the sum to infinity of an arithmetic series. What is a sum to infinity? Well, it is when you take a sequence that has infinitely many terms, it goes on and on and on, and you take all of those terms and you add them all up. But surely, the answer will always just be infinity if you add up infinitely many things. Well, not always. Let's do an example, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to create a geometric series by taking a piece of paper and folding it in half. Now, what you see in front of you there is a representation of two pieces of paper. So that yellow bit there represents one complete piece of paper. So the first term of our series is one piece of paper. The second term is going to be half of that, right? So there you see, we've added half to how much paper we have in total. And then everything that's colored in is S 2. It's the sum of the first two terms, the 1 plus the half. Then term 3 has got to be a quarter, because we fold a half in half, and it's going to look like that. So now S3, the sum of the first three terms, is the yellow plus the green plus the purple. It's all of that together. Term 4 is an eighth, and we can show it like that. Then S4 is the whole thing together. Term 5 is a 16th. Term 6 is a 32nd. And now S6 is everything you see there. And let's think, if you keep going and going, are you ever going to finish? No, because you're always only going to fill in half of that space remaining. So S infinity, if we go on and on and on forever, we're only ever going to cover that whole block. So S infinity is actually going to be equal to 2. So let's think about it in terms of some terminology. We can label a geometric series as either being divergent or convergent. For a divergent geometric series, the sum to infinity, when we add everything up infinitely, we get positive or negative infinity. And for a convergent geometric series, if we add everything up, it actually adds up to a constant value, like that previous example we just did. So if you put it on a graph, divergent is just going to go on and on up forever. But for convergent, it's actually going to approach a value. How do we tell them apart? Divergent geometric series always have consecutive terms that get bigger and bigger in magnitude. But convergent geometric series have consecutive terms that get smaller and smaller in magnitude, such as a paper being folded in half. To get something that gets bigger every time, we've got to multiply by a number bigger than 1 or smaller than negative 1. And to get something to get smaller each consecutive term, we've got to multiply by a fraction, a number between negative 1 and 1. But remember that the number we multiply each term in the sequence by to get the next term is called the constant ratio R. So how do we apply that? It means that for a divergent geometric series, R is less than negative 1 or greater than 1. But for a convergent geometric series, R, the common ratio, is between negative 1 and 1. So we can identify a convergent geometric series just by finding the ratio R and checking whether it lies between negative 1 and 1. So, is there a formula for this thing here? Well, we know that Sn is equal to Ar to the n minus 1 divided by R minus 1. But now we're trying to find the sum of infinity for a geometric sequence. So we want R to only be between negative 1 and 1. In other words, it's got to be a fraction. The only term in Sn that contains n is R to the power of n. So that's the thing we're going to be looking at here. So what happens to R to the power of n as n tends towards infinity? Well, remember that R is a fraction. Every time you multiply a number by a fraction, it is going to get smaller. So if we take n to infinity, then we are multiplying this fraction by itself infinitely many times. So as n becomes infinitely big, R to the n becomes infinitely small. And infinitely small, we can just call 0. So in our formula then, that R to the n becomes the limit as n tends to infinity of R to the n, and that is going to become 0. So then when we do a bit of algebra, we get that S infinity is equal to A divided by 1 minus R, and negative 1 has to be less than R, has to be less than 1. So that's the formula there for an infinite geometric series, given that it is convergent. So let's apply it. Precious is at an all-you-can-eat restaurant. I'm very jealous. Precious finds that she can continue eating forever, that's a bold claim, if every consecutive plate of food is 60% the size of the previous serving. Her first plate is 0.5 kilograms of food. How much food can Precious eat in total? So we find that each consecutive plate becomes smaller by a factor of 6 over 10. We're multiplying by 60%. So, what is the total amount that all of those plates of food are going to add up to? Let's use our formula here. So we've got S infinity is equal to A over 1 minus R. A is 0.5. That's her first plate of food. That's term 1. R is 60 over 100 because 60% is what we multiply by to get to the next term. And then if you put that into your calculator, you find that Precious, despite her massive claims, only eats 1.25 kilograms of food, even though she sits at the buffet forever. In summary, Sn is equal to A times R to the n minus 1 divided by R minus 1 for any geometric series that we're trying to add up, but we know how many terms we are adding up. Then, geometric series converge if negative 1 is less than R is less than 1. In other words, R is a fraction. And if it converges, then we can find the sum to infinity using the formula S infinity equals A over 1 minus R. So there we have it. Math applied to all the things you love. Video games, food, and, you know, actual math.